All right, welcome back to Kona. So when it came to the treasure map, I realized something when I was overlooking the footage. Is that this is north. So we're kind of looking at it the wrong way. So if you tilt it, you'll see that this is kind of in between. So there's the top there is the Blay House. And then you got the cabin, the shack, and the cabin B. So, yeah, we'll have to find that later. I'm not going to deal with it right now. We'll worry about it another time. So let's just continue on forward here.
Great care had to be taken searching this place full of oddities. Everything was important. The decor itself told a story.
I kind of want to progress a bit more. Maybe if I want to get the warm coat, I can probably be outside a little longer. Rosaire's house. Seems quite large. No key to unlock it with. There's a fire here. Someone home? Oh, what the?
Oh, my banana.
I wasn't expecting you.
Je m'attendais pas à ce qu'un étranger retentisse par ici. Moi de dire, je prends plus de chance depuis que ça rôde dans ce bout-là. J'ai ma carabine au bout du doigt, et puis bang, 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 si ça s'approche. Si tu veux du linge chaud, parce que t'es habillé comme un gars de la ville, je dirais pas non à une bonne bouteille de caribou. Puis tu pigeras ce que tu voudras parmi mes guenilles.
I don't have the beer. Crap. Let me get a little warm here first. Let me look at your
Dans mon temps, c'était comme sur l'image. On était vrai, fiers, forts, puis on avait le bon lieu de notre bord. Ah, la belle pétarade. En 17 que c'était. Et le Kaiser, il se souvient de moi avec ma belle carabine. Et bang, bang, que je lui disais. Bang, bang, bang. Ah, oh, le bon temps. Vois-tu le livre, là? C'est le Wendigo. Ouais, le Wendigo. Un guerrier qui devient un loup pour se venger de sa grosse peine. Et...
I was wondering if it would be the beast was a Wendigo. I know that's usually associated with native tribes up north in Canada, such as in Until Dawn. I didn't know it was Cree. I thought it was... There's another tribe of natives up there. Okay. Well, there was a time when hate waged war. Our hunters could decimate the great wolves who had taken our children. Our warriors could snap the necks of the cowards who had reached for our supplies. The deafening sound of rock and bone breaking was enough to satiate the hate, and the rivers of blood would express our remorse and apologies. Thus was balance maintained. Then came the whites. The legend of the Wendigo dates back to a time before what anyone but the tallest trees can remember. A time of great cold and great aspirations, when the ships came and spewed men and their fire cannons, plagues and spinelessness. Balance broke forever. The dead were piling up on our ancestral lands. Too many bodies covered in moss, too much blood spilled on our stone. Our bone-breaking hate did not suffice any longer. Shut up. One day, a young warrior who had lost everything, nieces, brothers, parents, and hope, fell to his knees in the middle of a small clearing covered in the blood of his fiancée, killed after having crossed the path of some whites passing by. He had seen everything and called out to the Great Spirit, called out to him with words that came so naturally to him, words that could only create a great river of blood and guts and a terrifying roar of screams. He called out to him for a force that no one had heard before. He became Wendigo. The whites were decimated under the icy claws of the Wendigo. The great tide of blood even pushed a few ships back out to sea. But the Wendigo was not yet done with his vengeance, for as long as the heart of one of his fiancé's murderers still beat on Cree territory, he would prevail. Ah, so maybe the murder of a Cree woman did create this problem. The elders say that it was the force of the ancestors' return to nature that turned the young warrior. In this clearing, where many ancestors had been buried in centuries past, a clearing now covered in blood spilled unjustly in a time where too many bodies were being buried. The ancestors heard the cries of the young warrior. Only in a remarkable time like this could the Wendigo have been born. His vengeance satiated, the warrior became Wendigo and went to rest forever. His frozen heart melted and disappeared, much like real snow come the spring. The storm that had befallen the Cree lands faded as well. There was much celebration. Balance had been restored, but the whites came back too. White hatred is never satisfied by rock and bone turned to dust. They arrived by the hundreds, armed with guns and torches, burned down every village, raped every woman, smashed the head of every newborn, tortured every man that fell into their grips. Never before had unbalance been so deep for the Cree peoples, and ever since, it has been told that one should be satisfied with the rivers of blood brought by hatred, despite the wrongfulness done to them, because remarkable hate comes at far too steep a price. The Wendigo was never invoked again, but in the hearts of the Cree people remained a fear that one day a young warrior would once again call out with remarkable hate. Because they know, through the wisdom brought by this legend, that the Wendigo would prevail, but that this victory would come at a great cost. The whites would come back. The whites would rule. None would be spared. So yeah, it looks like we're dealing with another Wendigo.
Gomme la belle rose la tuile, qui se donne au yob sur le mercredi des cendres. Fut-tu pas effrayant, je pense, toi, là.
Okay, not the greatest of toilets.
Touche pas à ça, l'enfant. Tu pourrais te faire mal.
Nothing.
Hey, la Corriveau. Bâtèche, ça te passe l'envie de te marier, la Corriveau. À Tuette ou ses maris, squeak, les uns après les autres. Pas de pitié dans le mariage.
Thanks for letting me snoop around your house.
C'est encore beau. Tout ce qui est vieilli est bien meilleur.
Come on, open.
C'est encore beau. Tout ce qui est vieilli est bien meilleur.
Okay, so we need to get...
Mon beau bonnet du beau temps. Puis ma ceinture, où ce que je glissais mon flasque. Le monde tournait plus con quand on s'habillait tout de même.
Okay, so we need to get a beer for him. There's the lake. I don't remember if I have a lot of stuff in here, so I don't know if I put beer in here. I did not. Let me deposit some things. I have a beer bottle. I So is my beer bottle not good enough? Let me take a look at it. We'll come back for that. I'll keep an eye out for some beer. Or caribou. As he calls it.
There, Carl had fed his mind, but had forgotten the harsh reality that his body also needed nourishment, especially in the dead of winter.
Ah. Okay. We'll just drive a little further along the road here. Slow down, Carl. Kind of a fork there. Load. Dear Mr. Lamoth, here's the spark plug you ordered for your Olympic Ski-Doo. This model, being very popular, has made it difficult to use a brand new part as quickly as usual. Thank you for choosing the Garage Polfin Enfil in Shibogamo. Sincerely, Katem Polfin. Okay.
Sometimes, and especially around here, people are so possessive with their land, as a dog is with hydrants.
The wolves were here too. Ah, we can break that. Let me just get the pincers from the car. Moth's garage.
What good was a motorless car? The mechanic sure had an odd way to go about repairing things.
Snowmobile ski? Ah, so are you gonna get a snowmobile?
Sorted by color, from the whitest to the greenest.
Ugh.
Or in other words, from the freshest to the sourest.
Nasty. Okay, so the hoof prints lead there. Take a look at that later. Can we go inside?
Another worrisome victim of this ice. This one seemingly petrified in action. The poor man, before being frozen solid, seemed to have been defending the entrance to his cabin. But from what?
A Wendigo. We'll take a look at him in a moment.
The week of October 5th, thought Carl. That was this week.
Okay.
The plug should have been here by now.
Yeah, it's in the mail. We saw that. I'm expecting a nice spark plug around the week of October 5th. It's already paid for. I guess just to remind himself he's done that.
The shape of this machine, almost straight out of Star Trek, was out of the ordinary to say the least. It felt like this thing could fly up into space at any moment.
Homemade flying saucer. Life never ceases to amaze me. Headlight. Ooh. Turn that off. Nothing of interest for us.
To all appearances, Carl concluded, the owner of the place had moved more essentials from his house inside the garage. Peculiar man indeed.
Something isn't right when your bed is in your garage.
The very first steps of man on the moon were made more than a year ago. The event had surely captivated the mechanic's mind for him to still keep this around.
Yeah. Something he was really fascinated with. Just let me double check everything else. Okay, we do need to repair this eventually. Let's inspect. Can't really see anything. Oh.
Something very important must have been in there for the man to take such time and effort to hide it. But Carl didn't know how to reach it.
So one of these buckets. I think it's this one. Let's see. Thank you.
Carl had a hunch that there had got to be a plan somewhere that could help him put this thing back together.
I'll look for that in a moment. I see. Okay, I found a gas can in one of my playthroughs. I can't remember which one. So I need to fill that up and maybe fill that up, and then we can power up the snowmobile.
It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. Carl hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the wealth contained in Lamotte's lands.
I'm just kind of exploring here, narrator. Give me a moment. Go inside.
These scribblings were undoubtedly the mark of a tormented mind. Something wasn't right in the poor mechanic's head.
Apparently, Lamoth is a rock collector. Oh, yeah. No caribou. Oh, there it is. I was wondering where there was a stove. Alright, good. We can heat up.
Carl deducted this was a map of the area. Were those pins pointing to places of interest?
Goodness, I wish I could make a note of that on my map. Because one would be a secret project. Oh, it looks like he did. So there is the cave. Secret project. We'll take a look at that in a moment. An ice cave over there. Because that pin is obviously the cave. Others, I think. Okay. Alright. What's this?
Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves? Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves?
Nothing in there. Various phones. More film.
The man has a passion for intergalactic things. Back then, people were obviously scared of the Russian atomic bomb, but an invasion by extraterrestrials was a legit fear as well. Seems like the mechanic had made his choice.
Yeah, about this time there was a lot of, like, a UFO, like, a purported alien abductions. Dear Mr. Lamoth.
Roswell, Atamipek, same story. Large deserts conducive to extravagant follies.
Following up on your complaint, I'm afraid that the police cannot support your claim alleging the sudden appearance of a man who came from outer space on your village's territory. Manifestly, what happened at Roswell in New Mexico left a deep impression on you, and we would urge you to consult with a physician as soon as possible. Regarding future potential complaints, let it be known that the Judicial District of Abitibi does not believe in Little Greenman. Regards Pierre Valjean, Clerk Surete de Quebec. Okay. So he probably thought the Wendigo was... Apparently the Lamoth is a rock collector. Okay, I guess there's nothing else. At least from what I'm seeing. Stealing road signs is prohibited by law. Still need one more thing for that. I need to figure out how to get to that. Basically follow the wolf prints. There's wolves, I see them. So yeah, I have a hatchet. Oh, it's hurt. But not too hurt.
Carl never thought he would be dancing with the wolves.
I probably could have avoided it. Oh well.
Someone whose life had been taken with blunt force. Where was the body now? Why had it been buried, only to be dug up later? Carl felt as though he was shrouded in fog.
The caribou prints are surrounding it. Over here. The secret project.
That large antenna in the middle of the path. Undoubtedly ideal in attempting to communicate with little green men. Was quite awkwardly placed. There had to be a lever to control it. Maybe behind it. Carl would have to figure out how to reach it.
Maybe it's up here?
Mm-hmm.
There's a bike there. Just want to see what's over here. Nothing much. Okay, let's take a look inside. Oops, sorry.
Terminals appear to be linked together, but for what purpose? So that's where the generator key was hiding. All that was left was to use it. The unexpected source of heat, but not as much as his freezing hands.
Did that work? Damn it. Okay, so I'm just looking it up. So here we need positive charge there. There. This one's right. There we go. Okay.
Open sesame. At last. So big an effort for an oh-so-tiny piece of metal.
So that was the snowmobile key? I'm glad we have that. And we will be needing it. Blueprints.
If some daring person could manage to get their hands on the missing parts, Carl was willing to bet that the craft would have taken flight.
Suspension. This suspension has way too many parts. Taking a puzzle apart is easy, but putting it back together is another story. I patched everything up but the tracks. I left them close by. Ski. Don't drink and work. Don't drink and work. Don't drink and work. I'm misplacing parts of the machine. Lejean came to help me work on the machine yesterday afternoon. For the most part, he helped me chuck my bottles down to the last drop. I think we tried to ski or something. Bad idea. I still haven't found that one ski we lost in the process. Body. That would make a nice beach chair pad. I just need to get all the parts to reassemble it. This lamp is pretty well made, suitable for use even in the harshest of winters. I think I'll place it on my top secret prototype in the garage. Space has got to be pitch black and damn cold after all. Steering. I have to hurry up and fix this machine if I'm to travel around the powder snow all winter. Alright, I've managed to untangle and replace the brakes cable. Dead on time for October. Now how about a nice and light blanket of early snow to let this fun begin? Notes. December 1969. Stunts. They're a blast when you're 12 and you go ahead and break your brother's old bicycle, I suppose. Well, I managed to damage my beautiful, brand new snowmobile after only 2 days of acrobatics. Fixing it up will take a while. I'm thinking a year at the very least, damn it. March 1970. I need to get my hands on that yellow suit, including the helmet that goes with it. Just like in the ad. I'll order them from the bay. September 1970. I think I'm done. All that's left is, 1. Install all the parts, 2. Get the spark plug I've ordered back in August and still haven't received, 3. Find the snowmobile's ignition key. I think it's on my bunch of keys, which should be on the generator powering my top secret workshop down south, and which I'm working on my equally top secret machine. Anyways, gotta find that key. 4. Now that I've siphoned off the snowmobile's gas to feed my truck, I'll have to refuel it if I'm to wander in the snowbanks at some point. Okay. So that was what we needed for the snowmobile. Let's put on what we can.
Okay. By following the plan, Carl was led to believe that the snowmobile's parts had to be scattered about in the vicinity.
I don't have that. Place track. I don't have the track. Got a lot to find still. Okay. Alright, well, I think that is a good place to stop for now. Thank you very much for watching, and we will be progressing further. And I will see you next time with more Kona.